Do you have any idea how much power your toaster, your refrigerator, or your clothes washer and dryer use? Well, it's really important to understand this if you're going to be building an off-grid system.
How much power do we have to play with?
Barely enough to run this coffee pot for 9 hours.
Understanding power is fundamental, and it's one of my favorite things to do whenever I'm mixing and matching voltages, because it gives me the ability to actually know with hard numbers what the amount of energy is actually doing or capable of. In my last video, I talked about Ohm's law, and it's the backbone to all electrical concepts. If you missed it, be sure to go back and watch that one. You might want to do it now, but you could also just wait until the end of this video. Power in simple terms is the rate at which energy is used or produced. To find power, all we do is we multiply current by volts. So it's P equals I times V. So I keep saying power, but really when I think about it, I use the other word, which is watts. So oftentimes you're going to hear things like this appliance pulls 1500 watts, or this one is a 3500 watt fill in the blank. Or most likely you've heard of a 100 watt light bulb, although those are discontinued and it's kind of a bummer. Now, if I tell you that one of my appliances uses 120 volts, that's interesting, and you know that you can't run it off of just a regular battery, but that's about all you know. And likewise, if I tell you that it needs 30 amps, but you don't know the voltage, you still have no idea how much power this appliance actually needs or consumes.
You can't run a vacuum cleaner on 12 amps, John.
However, if I tell you that this item uses 3600 watts, now you know exactly how much power is being used or could be used. Does that make sense? So you see, amps don't tell you how much power is being drawn because it could be amps at 12 volts or 48 volts or 240 volts. Or if I just tell you the voltage, but you don't know how many amps, you really have no idea and you can't just figure it out. However, if I tell you 3,600 watts, you know exactly the power draw and consumption. A quick side note, I'm not an electrician and that's why I actually put this out. I know what it's like to be someone who struggles with all of this electrical theory and don't really know exactly where to start or what all of this means. And so that's why I wanted to put this together and help others who are like me. And before you say, you're not qualified to talk about this, you're right, I'm not. But the document that I'm actually going off of is Wiring Unlimited by Victron Energy. And it is a fantastic document that you can download as a PDF or pull up as a web page. And then you can digest all of this to your heart's content. I'm going through it and putting it in video form because if you're like me, that's the way you like to consume content. So that's the heart of this series, and I hope it helps. If it's helping you, let me know in the comments below. So let's talk about some real-world applications. Here I've got a 12-volt lithium battery, and let's say I've got a fan that draws 5 amps. So if I want to know how much power is actually being drawn, if I don't want to know how many watts are being pulled into the fan, I'm going to need to do a little bit of math real quick. I'm going to take my 12 volts and I'm going to multiply that by 5 amps, and that's going to give us 60 watts. Super simple. But now let's say that we have that same fan, but instead of running off of a 12 volt battery, it actually plugs into the wall into a standard outlet. It's still drawing 60 watts, but how many amps is it pulling whenever it's plugged into a 120 volt outlet? For this, we need to take the 60 watts, divide them by 120 volts, and that gives us 0.5 amps. And this is why I'm always converting to watts instead of thinking about things in amps, because on a 12 volt system, it's 5 amps, but on a 120 volt system, it's only half an amp. So if we take our different systems, like my 48 volt system, my 120 volt system, or my 240 volt options, then if I need to know how much energy is being used, I always convert to watts. It's super important that you know how to convert your volts, your amps, and your watts from one to another. And if you know two of them, you can always find the third, just like an Ohm's law. And now you have what you need to be able to always know how much power is being used. If you're into this sort of thing, definitely check out our next video where we're going to talk about conductivity and resistance. It's going to be riveting and I hope you join us for it. It's good information to know and it's going to help you along your solar journey. Speaking of your solar journey, if you are purchasing any parts along your way, I'd greatly appreciate it if you would use my links in the description and right over here, because this is going to allow me to keep utilizing my time to make these videos, because when you use the links, it doesn't cost you anything extra and it helps me out a ton. Thanks in advance for using those links. I'm Eric, encouraging you to live faithfully and prepare thoroughly for good times or bad, and I will see you on this video about conductivity and resistance, or check out this one. YouTube thinks it's best for you.